Hi everybody, I'm Naufal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss regarding a new topic, that is qualitative research design. Last class we have discussed regarding quantitative research design and different types of quantitative research design, that is experimental research design and non-experimental research design, and we have discussed in detail regarding what is research design. So if you are watching this video first time, I will give the link in the description box. Please go through that also so that you will get an idea regarding what is a research design and the classification of research design and what is quantitative research design and regarding experimental research design and non-experimental research design, you will get an idea. Okay. Today we are going to discuss regarding qualitative research design. So what is mean by qualitative research design? Qualitative research design means in this the researcher will in depth deeply, the researcher will study the human behavior. The researcher will in depth examine the human behavior. Okay, so qualitative research design means in depth examination of the human behavior, and the data are collected in descriptive form. In qualitative research design, the data are collected in descriptive form, that means in words. Okay, through explanation only, not in numbers, not in numerical form. In numbers you will not collect data in qualitative research design. Data are collected in descriptive form, as well as data are collected through direct interaction with the people. Okay, directly interacting with the people only you will collect the data in qualitative research design. So qualitative research design means it is the in-depth examination of the human behavior, and data are collected in descriptive form, and data are collected with directly interacting with the people. Okay, that is qualitative research design. Let's see the different classification of qualitative research design. It is mainly classified into 6 types. We can see one by one. First one is phenomenological research. Phenomenological research. I will start with an example for your better understanding. Suppose an earthquake has occurred, or a flood has occurred, or any accident has occurred. Now, the researcher want to examine the experience of the human being with that accident. Okay, he want to examine the experience of the person who are the victim of that accident or that earthquake or that flood. Victim means the person who is injured or the person who is exposed to that accident or to that earthquake. So in phenomenological research, what the researcher will do, he will examine the experience of the victim to a particular accident by collecting the data, by collecting the information from the person, from the victim only. Are you getting or not? That is phenomenological research. So in phenomenological research, the researcher will examine the human experience. What is the experience? It may be any accident, it may be any earthquake or flood, any disaster. He will examine the human experience and collect the data from the victims only. Collect the data from the person who are exposed to that accident. For example, a phenomenological research on the experience of flood in Kerala, in selected villages of Kerala. Okay, suppose flood has occurred in Kerala. So the researcher, what is he is doing? The researcher is doing that he is conducting a study on the experience of flood in particular villages of Kerala with the victims only. So the victims will give the information, such and such experience was there, their feeling at that time, how they have experienced the flood. Got it? That is phenomenological research. Next one is ethnographic research. Ethnographic research means here the researcher will try to learn regarding some culture, and he will collect the data from that culture by living with that culture. For your better understanding, we know blood donation in some villages of India, still the people are thinking that blood donation is a sin, it is against the wish of the God. Okay, so what the researcher is doing, he is living with that culture. Okay, ethnographic research means studying the culture by collecting the data by living with them. So what the researcher will do, he will live with that particular cultural group people and he will collect the data from them without knowing their knowledge. They don't know whether the researcher is collecting the data or not. He will live with that particular cultural groups and he will collect the data. What is their view regarding blood donation? Okay, so here ethnographic research means it is related to a study of the culture by collecting the data by living with them. The researcher will live with that particular group and he will collect the data and he will get an idea what is their view on blood donation. I am giving the example only. Okay, what is their view on particular thing, to understand that different cultural peoples are there around the world. So the researcher will live with them and he will identify what is their view on a particular topic. So he will try to learn regarding the culture and he will collect the data by living with them. That is ethnographic research. Got it? Next one is grounded theory. Grounded theory, in the name itself you can see a theory. That is, in grounded theory the researcher is discovering or developing a new theory. Okay, after collecting the data and after analyzing or examining the data, okay, after examining the data the researcher will develop or discover a new theory. It is mainly used in social science. Okay, grounded theory method is mainly used in social science. So the researcher will collect the data and researcher will examine that information and he will make a new theory, because maybe previous datas are not available with that topic. Previous datas are not available, or nobody has previously not done a research regarding that topic. So what the researcher will do, he will develop a new theory regarding that topic by collecting the data and by analyzing that data. Okay, so grounded theory means, grounded means from the data only. The root of the theory is from that data only. From the data the researcher is conducting or he is developing a theory. So from the data only he is making a theory. That is called grounded. It is, the root is from the data only. Got it? Next one is case studies. Case study is very familiar to you as nursing students. In your records and all you have written so many case studies. From the name itself, studying of a case, okay, you are studying a case. That is case study. You are studying a single case. You can explain case study as in-depth study of a single case. You are studying a single case, for example heart attack. You are studying regarding heart attack in deeply. You are studying regarding heart attack. The case will be single, but you can select one patient or a group of patient, but the case should be heart attack only. That is myocardial infarction only. That is case study. That is in-depth study of a case. A single case you are studying in deep. Got it? So the case should be single, the number of the sample should be single patient, or you can select a group also, but the case should be single only. Always keep it in mind, in case study the case should be single case. That I have given the example. If you are studying regarding heart attack, you have to select only heart attack patient only. That is myocardial infarction patient only. Next one is historical research. From the name itself you will get an idea. That is historical means something is related to history, that is related to past. So in historical research the researcher will collect the past data. The researcher will collect the past data, that is the old datas, and evaluate the old data. Researcher will evaluate the old data and he will collect the old data. After collecting the past data and after evaluating the past data, he is making a relationship with the present as well as what will happen in the future. What is happening in the present and what will happen in the future. For example, a researcher wants to study regarding the development of nursing in India. How nursing was developed in India. So he is collecting the past data related to the nursing and development of India in India and regarding the first nursing college, how nursing was implemented in India. He is collecting that data. And he is correlating that with what is happening in the present and what will happen in the future also. So the better example is an historical research on the development of nursing in India. A researcher is studying how nursing was developed in India. Got it? That is historical research, means collecting the past data and evaluating the past data. Afterwards you are trying to find out what is happening in the present and what will happen in the future. That is historical research. Next one is action research. Action research, that means an action is taken to solve the problem. In action research, in order to solve the problem, an action is taken or some implementation has done. A problem is identified. To solve that problem, an action is taken and studying the effect of that action. For example, a researcher finds that nursing practice in India is not proper. So he is thinking that implementing American nursing practice in India. Okay, that is his study, an action research on implementation of American nursing practice in India. Okay, so he find the problem that nursing practice in India is not proper. He is making a solution that implementing American nursing practice will solve the problem, and he is studying the effect of that implementation, effect of American nursing practice. Okay, identifying the problem and taking action. You are implementing something to solve that problem and you are studying the effect of that action. What action was taken to solve the problem and how was the effect of that action? That is action research. Got it? That's all regarding qualitative research design. We will meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.